I hereby call this agenda review meeting of the Nacogdoches ISD Board of Trustees to order. Let a record show that a quorum is present and notice of this meeting was legally posted in accordance with the Texas Open Meetings Act. Board Member James Irvin is unable to attend today's meeting. All items on today's agenda are for discussion only and no action will be taken at this meeting. Please join us in turning your cell phones to the silent mode for our meeting. And we're going to move into our consent agenda, it looks like. Just before I do that, though, I just want to kind of verify and give Dr. Hill an opportunity. Did we want to save the public hearing for the Thursday night, or is there any preliminary information we need to review today?
It is totally up to you all. It's an annual report that's required by TEA.
Okay.
There are a couple of pieces that are not in the TAPER report, for example, that we do have to report according to our Texas Education Code, but it's our number of counselors.
Okay.
We kind of know that, but there's 20. But outside of that, it's pretty standard.
All right.
And that the TAPER this year is in two different formats. They have a PDF version that you're able to download, and we have it in your board book. And then there's an interactive online one that's available this year for the public, of course, to view.
All right, so I will kick this to the board then. Would you like to do a review of the TAPER before our public hearing next week, or would you like to save that item for the public hearing?
I'm fine to wait, but it'll be available for us to look over before the meeting so that we
yes,
know.
Ma'am. Okay. All of your sections are in there.
It's in our rubric, and I don't want to rush this. I want to avoid, I know that we do have to do the full extent of the public hearing next Thursday, so that would be duplicative information if we review it today. So I really want to fill you guys out and see where you, what you guys think about that.
There's a lot of material I've gone through it all, but I have not
TAPER,
read it all.
Yes, TAPER is extensive.
But I did
yes.
have one question. I don't know that it makes a big difference, but I noticed at graduation last year there were a lot of people that went to the military. When it talks about kids graduating and they go to a four-year college or a two-year college or other, it doesn't yes. mention how many kids go to the military. Is that just not required to be reported?
It is, yes, sir. It began.
Is it in our material that
there,
we?
In the TAPER report, yes, sir. There is a section.
I missed it.
For that, and I'm trying to think specifically.
I thought we had a very high number that went to the military last year.
Yes. May I show you in a few minutes? Would
sure.
that be okay?
Sure.
Exactly where it is. Yes, sir.
That'd be right. Thanks.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Cassette, what are you?
Next
what is
Thursday.
Your feeling?
Next
Thursday. Thursday, next week.
Mm-hmm.
All right. That'll give us a little bit more chance to review because the TAPER is extremely extensive. So that'll give us a little bit more time to review the hard copy and be prepared. Right. All right. So with that, then we will move into item three, the consent agenda. Item B, business office reports, Mrs. Barbrick.
Good afternoon. All right. We will begin with the budget amendments, and they are they begin on page 526. The first budget amendment is correcting some licensed counselors to they were coded to Fund 11. We're moving them to 31. Item B, we hired some more coaches, which the coaches were budgeted, but their stipends for their athletics were not, and so I am adding that to the budget.
Can you tell us what coaches? You said we've hired some new coaches. Can you?
They were hired at the beginning of the year, so I'm thinking of McMichael and Moses each got one.
Okay. So they were middle school levels, what you're thinking?
Well, they would all either be middle school or high school. The ones that come to mind specifically are there were two at the middle school.
All right. Would you mind sending us that information, the coaches that those positions, the new positions that's covering? Does that make sense for this,
mm-hmm.
the stipends
yes,
that
yes.
we're talking
mm-hmm.
about?
Yes. Mm-hmm. It could also be other than new positions, but a new, I'm trying to figure out a best way to word this, we may have only had two assistants and one coach last year, and now we have three. It could be that as well.
We'll get a memo.
But I will get that for you, yes.
Yeah, would love to see those, what we're changing there.
Yes.
Okay.
C, we had quite a large number of athletic playoff games, and so I am budgeting the revenue and the associated expenses. D, Nettie Marshall is moving money to send one of their administrative team to support some training, so they're moving funds. E, here we are using funds. E, F, and G are all for maintenance. We're moving funds out of fund balance to purchase equipment for custodians, for maintenance, and then as well, G is for two vans and six trucks.
So that would be, those are all action items on this agenda, correct?
That's correct. H, donations that were received from the athletic booster clubs. We're budgeting the revenue and then expense so they can spend it.
Ms. Barbary, when you say booster clubs?
This combines several of them. In the donations, they're detailed out.
Okay. Those people who donate, do they specifically, they say which booster club that money has to go?
Yes, and in the donations report, it is specific at who gave what.
Okay, for lack of, eliminate confusion, for example, football is called quarterback club.
Okay, no, I don't get that information.
Yeah. And girls soccer, for example, called gold club.
Okay.
In other words, it is specifically say which earmarked for their, take the confusion away from some coaches who say, okay, the money's supposed to go to me, or going to the booster club, and booster club goes to football. In other words, it would be more specific to say which organization received that money.
Well, in the donations, it does.
It does?
Yes.
Okay.
Which is just further down in this.
I'm sorry.
The donations detail is in this.
Yes,
later
the
donations.
But I guess my personal confusion was the booster clubs. And it went to the warm-up for football, right?
Well, this includes more than one booster club in this budget amendment.
Well, I understand. I'm trying to clarify myself. A portion of it, I believe, went to football.
Yes.
And a portion went to boys basketball.
Girls basketball.
Okay. Girls basketball, $100-some
yes.
dollars. Anyways. Instead of saying the booster clubs, I guess you're right, and I'm right at the same time. Specifically say, this amount for this, this amount for that. And I know that's how you did it. Okay.
Yes. For the donations, it's detailed.
Right.
For the
right.
budget amendment, I've combined them.
Yes. Okay. When I was the athletic director, and then some coaches would come to the meetings, following, they would come question me why booster clubs goes to that direction instead of saying booster club rather than club.
Mm-hmm.
But I had to explain to them it's summarized. As
yes, in the budget amendments it is.
Right.
And then I is a donation received for social workers, so that is the revenue and then expense for them to spend the funds.
I ask a quick question. I'm going to jump back up to item C just to make sure I'm understanding it correctly, Mrs. Barbary. So from the athletic playoff games, we actually had a total of just over $32,000 that we received.
That is correct.
From other schools who took advantage of our facilities, correct?
That is correct.
All right.
And in putting those facilities, those playoff games, we hired many people and paid
yes.
fees to.
Absolutely.
Right. So then
yeah.
we turn around and have to.
Yeah, pay the personnel to work, of course. And I'm blown away that we were able to generate a little over $32,000
yes.
in playoff games.
Yes.
That's wonderful.
That's the most we've ever
done.
Yes.
Fantastic.
And on the top of that, our booster clubs or athletic clubs or ag department get a concession stand get benefit.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. So there's actually really locally we were able to generate even far above that when you consider the fundraising the band and the FFA were able to do.
Overall, actually helped the city's economic as well. And soccer season is ahead, so I'm sure you're going to get a lot more.
Oh, wonderful. That is really exciting.
Ms. Fitch, I have a question. I think because Matt Ruff is here. On the vehicles, when we get rid of Nacogdoches Independent School District vehicles, do we wash them, or is it required they have to take the stuff off of that?
Yeah, we take the stickers off the sides of the trucks.
So when somebody's driving around in those old trucks, if they still can drive them, then they will not say that it's Nacogdoches Independent.
Correct.
Okay, and that we do that also with our buses that we.
Right.
Just, okay.
Any other questions on budget amendments? All right, moving on to page 533 and 534. This is a detail of donations that were under $2,500, as well as non-cash donations. Any questions on those donations?
On the Disabled American Veteran, the $200 for social services, where do you direct that money to? Is that?
That was budget amendment I that we just went over. So the social workers get it.
Oh, okay.
On page 535 and 536, our detail of our donations, cash donations over $2,500. So from the football booster club, they donated $5,000 that goes towards football player warm-ups, and then a coach's clinic, again for football. And then the girls basketball booster club donated $320. The investment report is on page 537. Again, we received interest that was sent to us. That's why you see a negative $4,103. Nothing was purchased or sold during the month.
When we received those interest checks, does that go into fund balance? Or where does that money?
It will eventually go. It depends.
Okay.
Right now, it's going into fund balance. Now, as it grows, like if at the beginning of the year, I budget so much for interest.
Okay.
If we exceed it, then I may, and I see we need money somewhere, then I do a budget amendment to reflect that. If
okay.
not, then it goes into fund balance. And then the rest of the reports are just our normal monthly reports. I would just ask if you have any questions on any of these. I will take those.
So this includes cash flow, check register, capital improvement projects. Any questions on these items? All right. Thank you, Mrs. Barber.
You're welcome.
Then we've got an item on the consent agenda for C, purchases over $25,000. This would be Mr. Owens. That is page 572 in our board book.
Yes. Good afternoon. Excuse me, President Fitch, board members, interim
Superintendent Fraley. Two years ago, we signed a three-year contract with Microsoft for all of our licensing. It's a site license. If you do look, I'll explain a little bit on 573 is the quote, and we actually pay for how many employees are using computers. That's how they base our license. Then they give us license for all of our student machines. It's under the education. Well, we're coming, this is the third year of the agreement, coming to the end. They've actually raised that amount, $6,685, to after talking to my representative at CDW. They're doing that to try to leverage us into a different type of agreement next year. We can go on year by year at this price or as it fluctuates and goes up, or they've got a different agreement that he's not real sure about. We'll know come May exactly what they've got, but I think it kind of caps. If you'll notice at the bottom of page 573, the Office 365 Pro subscription license, it says 10,000 there. It's going to cap us from them just throwing in that stray amount. We'll actually have to account for our license but not get charged. So this is the last year of the three-year agreement, and again, this is all the PCs on campus. This is our licensing.
So I show that we're actually purchasing license for 636 staff members, correct?
Correct.
And that is the full Office 365 suite?
Yes, ma'am. That includes, and it also includes the Microsoft Windows OS, the operating system.
Operating system as well. That's nice. It's comes out to about $65 per license. That's...
Yeah, that's
being in business. I know what we pay for our license. That's
yes,
that's
ma'am. The educational
that's a,
break is
that's
good.
A nice little nice little break for education. That's wonderful.
So that number of license is not tied in with individual employees. It's just employees. In other words, if an employee leaves, that license goes to the next employee. That takes that.
Yes. It's a site license. It stays on site, and this actually takes the heartache, headache. And if we bought a license with every computer, and then we bought Microsoft Office for every computer, then we've got to keep a database where those licenses are, you know. And then when they come out with a new version, we've got to buy a new license again. And so this actually makes it flow very nicely.
Well, and I said, as part of this agreement, you get all those student computers, 1,000 student computers licensed as well at no additional cost. So that's. That's a very, very good deal in my book when you're looking at over 1,600 computers will be licensed and ready to go.
When does this actually terminate, the contract we presently have? What date?
January of next year. And again, I'll get a quote just like this one, but before then I'll have it lined out for either another agreement, or we'll pay year to year, just depending on how it comes out.
Any questions?
Okay.
All right. Thank you so much, Mr. Owens.
Thank you.
So that will bring us to item D. Is there anything you need to discuss with us in regard to the election item?
Thank you, Madam President. Just to make an announcement that we will be having an election May 4th, potentially. The filing has begun as of January 16th. And you may file through February 15th for a trustee at large position 2, currently held by President Fitch, and trustee district 1, position 1 incumbent Reverend Irvin. So we'll be calling that election this month.
All right.
Should we have to?
Thank you. Mm-hmm. All right, that'll bring us to item 4, which will be on our action agenda item for next week. 4A, Mrs. Barbrick, resolution expressing intent to finance expenditures.
This can be found on page 597. What this resolution does is, before bonds can be sold, we will have some expenditures incurred. This allows them to be reimbursed.
That's it. So let's reimburse ourselves for any expenses prior to sale of the bonds.
All right. And I assume when we reimburse, that'll come back to the board to say, yes, we want to reimburse these expenses, or is that an administrative decision?
Well, on page 600. There is an estimate of what those we think those expenses will be, but no, we do not come back for each individual expense.
Once you've approved the calling of the bond and the projects, then we reimburse ourselves based on the expenses of the projects prior to the selling of the bonds. It really is an administrative action. We're not increasing the budget. It's like they're just reimbursing the budget. Just the fund balance.
So it's just an estimate at this point?
Yes, it's an estimate.
Okay, with that, I wondered, because I know that there were some ongoing projects that we were doing that we discussed would not come out of bond funds, right, but would come out of.
And those will be separated items. We have a separate accounting for those.
Okay. For example, the TJR audiovisual, I was thinking that was not part of the bond.
It was part of the bond.
Okay.
Because we have the folks on site working, doing that same type of work at the high school, we thought we would just get them while they're here to do it at TJR.
Okay.
And then we'll have the option of reimbursing ourselves, I think it's like $80,000, something like that, out of the bond proceeds or not.
Okay.
If we don't reimburse ourselves, then that I'll bring to the board at least to make you aware of it.
Right. And of course, my concern there is that we stay very true to using those bond funds for the intent that those bonds were passed and not, oh, well, we've got this other really important project, and while it may be a really important project, We need to look at funding it through fund balance, not through.
Every single one of these items were listed on the bond proposal.
Anything we reimburse ourselves from bond funds are things that were approved in the bond, in the bond referendum.
Yeah, and that's just where I want to kind of be safe and sure and know where we're at there.
Yep.
Right. So you mentioned the TJR audiovisual. That was part of one of the items listed for priority maintenance.
Any questions regarding this, guys?
Okay.
All right. That'll take us to item B, the bond bank account, and that's also Mrs. Barbara.
This is on page 601. I'm asking permission to open up a new bank account and a new investment account to deposit our bond funds in, as well as expense out anything for the bonds through these funds, and that way we aren't commingling our funds.
Keeping things separate.
So
wonderful.
So when you open that account, we put the funds that we get from the bond, and you're able to invest that money to get money off the money that we got off the bond?
Yes, that is correct. Now we have to be careful that we don't earn too much, but with interest rates as low as they are, that most likely will not happen.
And that will be with our current depositor, correct?
Yes, Bancorp South, as well as the investment. I'm wanting to use the Texas Class Investment Pool for the investments.
Any additional questions on the bank account or investment account? That'll take us to item C. Looking at our March calendars. You want to go ahead and brief us on that, Mr. Fraley?
Right now, based on the rotational plan that we use, we will have a board meeting during spring break. Probably don't want to do that, so we recommend that we move the works review and board meeting to the following week after spring break. Okay. And I forget what those dates are, but it will be the week after spring break.
So our board review would be the Monday coming back from spring break. Would that
Yes, ma'am.
Be a hardship on staff? Or
we'll make it work.
All right.
It's still a work day. So it'll be March 25th for the review and then March 28th for the actual board meeting.
All right. Any questions or thoughts on that? All right. That takes us to our executive session. So the board will now conduct an executive closed session to discuss items posted on our agenda pursuant to the following provisions of the Texas Open Meetings Act and is allowed by Texas Government Code sections 551.071, 551.072, 551.074, 551.076, and 551.129. No voting will take place in this closed meetings. Today's session is discussion only. It is now 12:25. Board is now reconvening into open session at 1:35. It was brought to my attention after we adjourned a while ago that I had been working from an old agenda of the meeting, so there's a couple of more items that we have here that I need to go back to address. And that would be under item 4, discussion and action. Item C, we'll hear it first. It's consideration of purchase of additional vehicles for plant service department, and that would be Mr. Martin and Mr. LaRue.
Sorry.
What?
Good afternoon. President, board members, Mr. President, what questions can I answer?
Yeah, we kind of talked to this a little bit earlier, but we're looking at purchasing with 3 vans and 2 and 6 pickup trucks.
Two vans.
And if you see some of them, you know it's about time. That's all it is. That's all this is.
Is someone going to actually pay us for the ones we're not recycling to other guys?
We have an auction service that we work with that does all of our auctioning, furniture, and vehicles. So they'll get auctioned off.
We'll get something. We don't have to pay to give them away.
No, we don't have to pay them all the way.
Just curiosity, we always had 2 vans parked behind the complex.
Yeah, they're parked in my lot in plant services, and they're on the auction block also.
Good.
So Ralph, on maintenance of our vehicles like these, do we do our own maintenance? I mean,
we do some maintenance. We're currently engaged in conversation with CTE at high school.
Okay.
To let them take over all of our maintenance. We hope to start that next fall. We have an agreement with a local quick change oil place that takes care of the basic oil change and things like that every 3,000 miles. We hope to move that to the high school. It's a matter of them getting on a fleet program, stocking the right oil filters, put all that, which we're working on, and I'll give the students there at the high school some real practical.
That's great.
Oh, that's cool.
That's great.
We're excited about it. And they won't be able to turn them over as quickly, so we're going to have to do some drop your vehicle off and get somebody else's vehicle for that rest of that day. But we're going to work through all that. I think it's a good opportunity for both of us. It will trim our costs
and give experience.
And give them some great experience. Because we have over 20 vehicles just in our white fleet, and they're in a big variety of vehicles.
So we're looking at, basically, if I'm looking at this rundown here, we'll be replacing 4 2003 vehicles, 2 2002 vehicles, and the 2 you have listed here that are 2012s will be rotated.
They'll be recycled.
Recycled to replace a 1999 and a 2005.
Right.
So these are all, we've rang a lot of service out of them.
Well, we have, in a personal truck, you might get a little more out of them, but remember these are all, every trip is about 3 miles long. Divide that into those numbers, you know how many trips they're making, but it's a lot harder on a vehicle to start it up and go 3 miles and take a nice long trip.
And these are the oldest vehicles in your fleet?
Yes. Well, we have a couple that are older. One in particular over at the warehouse has a pickup truck. The warehouse has the only garage-kept vehicles we have. They have a pickup truck and a large box truck and a van. They're all kept inside every night. That pickup truck is not used very much. It has low mileage, many years. It's in great shape. There's really no sense in recycling
it now. Because we purchased a new van last year for these guys.
Yeah, we got the warehouse a new van.
Yeah.
We're envious of their trucks since they get parked inside.
That's good. So we're looking, Ms. Barbara, I'm going to ask you real quickly. It looks like this is about $280,200 coming from fund balance. You feel good about that? How's our fund balance looking and all that good stuff?
I wouldn't ask for it if we couldn't do it. I wouldn't be asking for it.
That's right. I always like to give the CFO a chance to chime in.
Well, she reports to me. I'm the budget manager. She's administrator.
There you go.
That's great.
And she and I, we're on the same page.
Any additional questions about this item? All right. We will move to item D, consideration of purchase of custodial and grounds equipment. That is also Mr. LaRue. I believe that's on page 606 of our board book.
You should have a listing of all that equipment. Biggest chunk is grounds equipment. Just catching up some mowers, same situation, cycling out the mowers. Now on the mowers and the tractor, we will look at an option of trading in on the fleets, on the vehicle fleets. They won't take trade-ins on this deal because it's a state price. Both those dealers that we deal with, those equipments, may take trade-ins. If they will, we'll probably go their route because we'll actually, on paper, get more money on trade-in than we would if we go to auction.
What's the life expectancy on those lawnmowers, those drive lawnmowers? Because you guys like use them up pretty regularly. what do they last?
We can get 3 years out of them pretty dependably, 3 to 4 years.
Is there a type of lawnmower that would last longer, even though they might be more expensive?
Yes, there is, and we're looking at that. Couple of years when we open up new campuses and have more property to take care of, that's going to be part of that transition.
Okay.
To go to a larger turf mower, it's going to require a reorganization of grounds staff, not more staff, just reorganization to divide our campuses into large open campuses and campuses a little bit smaller so you could put the larger equipment on the right campuses. But pulling mowers out of the turf industry, out of golf industry, that are 11 to 12 feet wide,
okay,
have large turbocharged diesel engines.
We mow about how many acres are you? You have the number in your head?
Yeah, we have 400 acres of property that the district has. We maintain 300. We've got 99. We maintain the other 99. It's the ag farm, but it's a once-a-year brush hog, which is contracted out. So we maintain 300 acres. You know, some of that's parking lots, which we maintain, but a lot of grass, a lot of turf.
Yes. Ralph, I guess it was 2 years ago we bought that big tractor with multi mowers.
Right.
Are they
high
just?
School.
Yes. Is this?
It's a good example of what I speak of. As far as a large industrial turf mower, and one mower introduced out there cut the mow time 40%. Because we went from basically 60 inches or 72s to 11 feet. And the high school is a good example of a property that has lots of open space, big space.
Question for you as well, and I may be misinterpreting this. On the previous presentation, it kind of showed us what you were replacing, you know, on the trucks and stuff. On this, I see a list of equipment. I don't see what are we replacing. So is any of this new equipment, or is this all replacement?
All replacement.
Every bit of it.
Yeah.
All right.
We're arguing about which mowers to scrap.
Any
new tractor last 5 to 10 years?
New tractor, new John Deere tractor, 15, 20 years.
15.
So for us, the budget, Ms. Bumpert, we're okay with this finance, I mean, this purchase?
Yes, again, we'll be pulling from fund balance.
Fund balance, then.
There are a number of things, I know y'all done this in the past as well, that are some one-time or infrequent type purchases that we just hold off to see when we can afford it, because we don't want to interfere with the other operations of the district. But once that you've closed out a budget and you have a fund balance, we'll look at some one-time purchase types of things that are needed by the district. And so this is kind of what we're doing now. There may be a couple other things, nothing particular in mind, that may come up as well, but we're reviewing the needs right now of the district.
How much would you say that we have, I know that there are several projects like this that we need to address and stay ahead of and on top of. How much would you and Ms. Barbrick say that we have in fund balance that it would be safe to spend?
We're going to be revisiting all of that. These are things that, you know, don't really make a big dent in it, but it's real money. So we're going to be revisiting that, just look at how, and we don't want to spend everything that we have.
Right.
But we want to see what all we can cover that will make work easier for our staff.
Sure. Well, and I ask, and you're correct when you're talking about $131,000 and when you're talking about millions in the fund balance, right. My concern is that as we begin to tackle some of these projects that have been long overdue and very much needed, that we do it cognizant of where we're at, because they can add up quickly.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Exactly. And that's why we go back and forth to make sure we stay on the same page. And I do rely upon her expertise and experience as well to say when she gets to a zone of discomfort, we try to stop just short of that.
Right. And out of curiosity, I mean, everybody has kind of a different philosophy on that, Mr. Fraley. You know, some folks I've talked to, and they believe in you keep the operating reserve that you need in fund balance, and the rest should be spent. What is your philosophy on that?
I believe you take care of business. Whatever it costs, you take care of business. We're asking folks to do a lot of things. We don't give our folks the equipment that they need to do the job well. Who really should be held accountable? Mm-hmm. Bottom line. But there are a lot of needs that we have that folks have been afraid, because we get criticized for everything that we do. So do the right thing, what you need to be done, and folks want to criticize you, that's their business. We have work to do.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Mr. LaRue, for your hard work and your excellent administration of a key area of our needs in this school district. We are grateful to have you.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right. I believe, did I miss anything, guys? Did we get through all of our discussion? All right. We went a little out of order, but we got it knocked out. So I will entertain a motion.
I move that we adjourn.
So moved. Thank you, Mr. Neal.